Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, and in today's session we will be discussing about aldol condensation and cross aldol condensation. Now, as the name itself says, aldol means the product in this form is having aldehyde as well as alcohol. Now, first thing what you need to keep in your mind is that all aldehydes and ketones having alpha H undergo this reaction. They will undergo aldol condensation. They will undergo aldol condensation when in the presence of dilute base. In the presence of dilute NaOH, they will undergo condensation. Aldol condensation they are going to undergo. Fine. Now, we will take examples. Now, why they undergo? First of all, now, what do we actually mean by alpha H? If you have the CO and you have the next carbon atom, and this is the main functional group, right? I suppose I am talking about aldehyde, right? So, this is the main functional group. The adjacent carbon atom is called as the alpha carbon atom. Now, on this alpha carbon, if there is hydrogen, then it will be undergoing aldol condensation. Right now, why this is undergoing? Now, due to the presence of this carbonyl group is having a tendency to pull the electron toward itself, because the pi electron can be towards more electronegative oxygen atom, due to which this carbon will develop positive charge. When the carbon develops positive charge, this will definitely have a tendency to shift this side. So, the alpha H becomes more acidic. It is because of the acidic nature of alpha H. They undergo reaction in the presence of the base. I hope this part is clear. First of all, what I told you, aldehydes and ketones having alpha H undergo aldol condensation in the presence of the base. Why do they undergo? Because the alpha carbon, which is having the hydrogen, is more acidic in nature. Due to the acidic nature of the hydrogen present on the alpha carbon, the reaction occurs. Now, if you are asked to write down the products, how are you going to proceed? Now, first I am considering simple aldol. Now, simple aldol means the two aldehydes or two ketones which are participating are same. So, suppose you are asked to write down for acetaldehyde, CH3CHO. Okay, I am taking example for CH3CHO. Now, two molecules you need to write down. So, how you are going to proceed? You will write down first acetaldehyde like this with O. On the top, CH3CHO you will place on the top. The second aldehyde, when you are writing, you will expand its alpha H. You will expand its alpha H like this. On the top, you are going to write down. CHO I wrote. On the next carbon atom, this carbon is said to be alpha carbon. The alpha carbon's hydrogen I am writing on the top. Fine. Now, this was the first one, CO group I wrote. Both are CH3CHOs only, but only the way of writing is different. So, now what happens in this? This H will add on this particular O, and this carbon will add on this carbon, right? This CH2 will add on this carbon. So, what we can write now is CH3. This will become CH3. This is CH as such. This double bond will go now, O and H I am going to write down along with it. This attached to CH2 directly now, and this will be CH2. When does this happen? This happens in the presence of base, dilute NaOH. Right? Now, in the product which we wrote here, there is aldehyde and there is alcohol. That is why the name of the product we call as ald from aldehyde, all from alcohol. And what is the IUPAC name of this? We can number from this side 1, 2, 3, 4. On third position there is OH, so we'll be writing as 3 hydroxy, then the word root bute. single bond in al, 3-hydroxybutanal. Now, further what happens is, it is condensation we are talking about. That means water needs to be eliminated. So, this is heated then. On heating, water is eliminated. Which water you are going to remove from here? From this carbon, where we wrote OH. So, OH complete will go. And the carbon from where it got linked to it. From here, 1H you are going to remove. So, remove it and write the product. If we do that, what we will get is CH3. This will be written as CH only. This will be when two adjacent ones lose one, you know, group of atoms. So, it will be now a double bond. This will now be CH because H has gone from here, OH has gone from here. And you will write down CHO. This is the product. This is the condensed product. This is called as the aldol condensation product. Aldol condensation product. Now, what if we write down the IUPAC name for it? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. We will be numbering from right hand side. Correct? And there is no prefix present. The word root is bute, we will write. And then on this two position there is en, so bute to en and al. Al is at one position. So we wrote the name as bute to en al. This is simple aldol. Got it till here? Now we will take example of another simple aldol. Let us take example of acetone now. Same way, first acetone you will be writing with that CO on the top, right? And the second CH3 we are going to write down. Because this CO should be free to be attached on the right hand side. Something should be attaching from right hand side. This is one acetone. For the other acetone, alpha H I am going to open up like this. And this will be CO and CH3. Clear? Because what is acetone? Acetone is CH3, CO, CH3. Okay, so what I wrote is that first molecule ka CO should be up, second molecule ka alpha H you will open up such that it gets added on. Now this is just to explain what was acetone. In the presence of dilute base, sometimes you may have even barium hydroxide written here. Do not get confused, a base is required. So what did I tell you how it is going to add on? This H will be added on to O, this carbon will be added on to the next carbon. So what I will do here, I'll just copy down. Only way of writing, if you understand, no, writing product is very easy and aldol is a very important reaction. So I just added on, only way of writing it is correct. Now this is having the ketone product, that CO group and all. Sometimes you will also call this as ketol. Ketone is there and all is there. So it is ketol, aldol, ketol, they are the same. Now, what will be the name for this when we are naming it from right hand side? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? On 4 position, there are two things present. 4 position, there is hydroxy. So, 4-hydroxy. 4 position, there is methyl also. So, write down 4-methyl. This is all the prefix. After the prefix, we have to write down the word root. The word root is pent, single bonds in. And two position there is on. So, two on. Clear? Now, this is to be heated. I told you, whatever product is there is to be heated now. On heating, water will be eliminated. From where are you going to remove water? This is OH. And from this side, from where it got added on, from that particular carbon, you will remove one H. You will remove one H and write on the product. Only copy that thing, same thing we are now copying. This is CH3. As I said, from both something is removed, so it will now be a double bond. This will now be H, this will be CO and CH3. This is the product. This is the aldol condensation product. What if we write down the IUPAC name for this? You are going to number it from right hand side. 4 position there is methyl, so 4-methyl. The word root is pent. And 3 position there is ene, so 3-ene. fine, and two position there is one. So two one. This is simple aldol. Clear? So two examples are taken for simple aldol. Now, in case you are asked to write down the crossed aldol, what is the meaning of crossed aldol? The two reactants are not the same. Now, let's talk about crossed aldol. Suppose you are given a question, CH3CHO and CH3CH2CHO. When they are treated with dilute NaOH, what will be the products? That means you are expected to write down the aldol products. Fine. Now, how do you write the products? In this case, the two different carbonyl groups are there. Which CO to be written first? There will be a doubt. So, in such cases, there will be mixture of the products. Which mixture will be there? In the first thing, you will have two CH3CHO molecules only combining. That means two of such molecules only combining. Now, don't think we have taken two only. I am showing you one molecule here, but you are having one sample of acetaldehyde, one sample of propanol. So either two acetaldehydes can combine or two propanols can combine. If two propanols are only combining, then what? For the first propanol, you will write down CO on the top. For the second propanol, you have to show alpha H like this. You will have to show alpha H like this. All extra things you are going to put down. This is clear. This was the main carbon atom. This was the case, right? This is the main carbon. Next is alpha. So alpha H I wrote on the top. This extra CH3 I have put down. So either two acetaldehydes may combine or two propanols may combine, or first can be acetaldehyde like this and the second can be propanol. When you know this, the product writing will be easy for you. Or it can be the reverse. You may have propanol first, CO is provided by propanol, and alpha H is provided by acetaldehyde. So you will have four variety of the products. I hope it is clear. If you get two different carbonyl groups, then either, suppose if I number this as 1 and if I number this as 2, either both 1s can combine or both 2s can combine or 1 and 2 can combine or 2 and 1 can combine. That is the probability wise I have written. This is 1-1 combining. This is 2-2 combining. This is 1 and 2 combining or 2 and 1 combining. Okay, the first group which I wrote is providing alpha H. The first group which is written is providing CO and the second group which I wrote is providing alpha H. Okay, so now writing the product will be easy. Okay, try writing the products on your own. Just check, have you written the same? I've just written the products directly to save time. I've just added them first. Then from this OH, H is removed, you get the product. OH and H is removed, you get this product. I think this H has to be removed from here. From here, OH and H is removed. From here, OH and H is removed. You will get the products. And you can write down the IUPAC names on your own. Clear? Now, we'll take one more example. Now, suppose you are given acetaldehyde and acetone. Write down the products, aldol condensation products. So, same way. Let's number them as 1 and 2. Try writing. I'll just write down the combinations, the products you will write on your own. Okay. Either 1 and 1 can combine. Either 1 and 1 can combine. Or 2, 2 can combine. Or 1, 2 can combine. Or 2, 1 can combine. Clear? The first one is always providing CO group. So you will write down the CO group. The second one, 1-1 means both are acetaldehydes. That means the second one is also acetaldehyde. The same acetaldehyde is providing alpha H. You can complete the product. In the presence of dilute NaOH, the reaction is occurring. Or 2-2 can combine. 2-2 means CH3CO, all extra ones you will put it down. The second molecule will have alpha H like this. same way in the presence of. Then 1 and 2. That means this is providing alpha CO group, CH3CO group. And the second one is providing alpha H. Acetone is providing alpha H. You can write a product. Now it is 2-1. That means acetone is providing the CO group. And the aldehyde is providing alpha H. That means this you are going to write down later in the presence of the base. Just add on and remove water molecule on heating. So condensation product can be written. Fine till here. One more. Suppose you have this combination. What is this combination, children? This is benzaldehyde. This is benzaldehyde. And you're making it react with acetophenone. Acetophenone. Now, if we carry out the reaction of the two in the presence of the base, the reaction is always in the presence of the dilute base, then first thing, you check whether they are having alpha H or not. This is the main carbon having functional group. The next carbon, this is alpha. So this carbon is alpha carbon. On this alpha carbon, there is no hydrogen. That means this benzaldehyde cannot provide alpha H. So will the reaction occur? Yes, it can occur, because though benzaldehyde cannot provide alpha H, but it can provide CO group. It can provide, let me write C6H5 instead of writing that ring, just for convenience. Let this be CO group. Okay, so this can provide CO. What about this? Can this provide alpha H? Yes, it is. This is the main functional group. This side you have one alpha. This side also you have one alpha. This alpha doesn't have hydrogen. This alpha has. So this side alpha carbon can provide alpha H. So I will expand this and write. Instead of writing CH3, I will write as CH2. I'm going to reverse this side. This CO I will write here. And the ring I'm going to write down the other side. The carbon that is providing alpha H will be written facing CO group. Okay, so now this can be added on. How this can be added on? As I said, this will be written here, this will be written here. Okay, so now let us write down the product. It will be in the presence of the same dilute NaOH, C6H5. From here I am writing, this is CH, this H will be written along with O, this CH2 will be written along with this, and CO, and this will be C6H5. This will be considered to be the major product. Why? Because if I am taking this as number 1, this as 2, there is no possibility of 1-1. This is ruled out. Is there a possibility of 2-2? 2-2 means only two acetophenones combining. Yes, there is a possibility. So 2-2 possibility is there. Fine. I will write down this 2-2 also. Then if I am writing 1 and 2, yes, it is possible. 1 and 2, one is providing CO, another one is providing alpha. Yes. Can I write 2-1? Can this have CO? Yes. But this doesn't have alpha H. So this combination is not there. So there are two possibilities. Which possibility is written here? This is 1 and 2 possibility. Means the first one is providing CO and the second one is providing alpha H. This I have written. So 2-2 also I will write and show you. Why I am saying this is the major product? Also I am going to explain. What will be the name of this? The name of this is 1,3-diphenyl. This is the prefix. This is the main thing. 1 and 3 position there is phenyl. Right? Then you have the word root as pro. Then you add 2 position. This is one product I have written, but when you heat it further, it is going to lose water molecule also. So when it is going to lose water molecule, that product I will be, that name I am writing here. So let me write down that product. After removing water, it will be C6H5CH. This will be double bond. This will be CH now and COC6H5. Right. So its name I am writing 1,5-1,3-diphenyl and prop. And further you have 2 position in. 2, if I am numbering from here, 1, 2, 3. This will be my main chain, right? So 2, in one own. This will be my main chain, and from this side I am numbering it. If you want to name this, you will be writing OH also as hydroxy. So this name, children, is for the final product, that is after removing water. Did you follow this? So benzaldehyde was giving alpha CO group, and acetophenone was giving alpha H. Now let us see if the possibility of 2-2 is there. 2-2 means you have here C6H5 and CO. This side is CH3. And the other one is providing alpha H. That means this H, this will be CH2, this will be CO, and this will be C6H5. But only problem here is the two rings will be there, hai na? And there is alkyl group also present here. So here there is less hindrance. This is having just CO and that CH2. This can add on simply. Here due to hindrance, the product will be minor product. You can write on the product, it will add on, the product formed will be the minor product. You can add on here and then remove water molecule on heating. So two possibilities are there, but I have written here one major product which will be formed in this. Clear? So please practice, children, aldol condensation very nicely. It's a very, very important question in the board exam. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.